Hi everybody and welcome back. Now my friends, first things first, I would like to congratulate all of my MET students who were able to pass the board exam for teachers. My friends, congratulations, and you know, the entire MET family, we are all proud of you. Yun nga lang mga kaibigan, this video is not necessarily for you. Kasi alam ko naman na ang dami na bumabati sa inyo ng congratulations. Ang medyo nakakalimutan natin ng konti is yung mga kaibigan natin na hindi masyadong pinalad ngayong season. Kaya naman, my friends, if you're one of those persons who are not so lucky in this season, then this video is for you. So you might be asking, why am I making a video out of this topic? Well, kasi, my friends, I can feel yung bigat na dinadala ng mga kaibigan natin na hindi masyadong pinalad sa exam. Kasi I think they are now sad, they're all frustrated and disappointed. Kasi I think they feel that they were able to disappoint a lot of persons too. Like probably their families, their friends, their schools, their teachers, and most importantly themselves. Kaya nga mga kaibigan, I made this video to help you in a way to move on and move forward. Pero before I continue, my friends, let me first acknowledge si Paul Carillo kasi some of the insights in this video are from him. So Paul, shout out to you. Now, I was able to summarize all of my tips for you in 5 A's. Limang A's. The first A is accept. The second A is assess. The third A is act. The fourth A is aspire. And the last A is acknowledge. Now, ano nga ba ibig sabihin nito? I'll be explaining each of them in just a little while. Well, the first one is accept. Now, ano nga ba kailangan mong tanggapin? Well, maraming bagay. I think you need to accept the fact that you didn't make it. Even though how painful and how difficult it is, kailangan mo siyang tanggapin. And it is not easy. Tingin ko ito yung pinakamahirap na stage na kailangan mong pagdaanan eh. Lalo na ngayon, nakakalabas lang ng resulta and maybe all of your friends na pumasa ay nag-celebrate and here you are wallowing in self-pity. Pero mga kaibigan, I think, kailangan mo itong tanggapin. Kailangan mo talagang i-accept yung state mo, yung kapalaran mo, right? Kasi talagang wala ka naman magagawa if you will deny it. So that's the first stage, accept it. Ang problema lang mga kaibigan, some people are medyo insensitive na parang if they would see you, they would say, okay lang yan, yung okay lang yan. Which for me, is not a good remark to say. Kasi when you say okay lang yan to a person who is frustrated, parang you are discounting the feeling of that person eh. And you know what? It is not okay. And you have to accept that as well. Na ito ay hindi okay. And it's okay not to feel okay. You have all the reasons to, you have all the right to. Yun nga lang, the point is, mga kaibigan, you must do something about it. Which would lead me to my second point or second A, which is assess. Second tip is assess. Now, ano nga bang kailangan mong i-assess? Well, my friends, tingin ko kailangan mong balikan yung experience mo. And you have to assess kung ano ba yung mga points na kailangan mong pang i-strengthen, yung mga weaknesses mo na kailangan mong pang i-improve. And I think the next time around, you have an edge already because you have been there. Alam mo na yung kailangan mo talagang i-focus pa. Halimbawa, kung tingin mo nahirapan ka sa shading, then practice shading more. Halimbawa, nahirapan ka sa prof ed, then read more about prof ed. Major, read more about your majors, right? So it means, my friends, you need to assess what happened in the past so you would know what to do in the future. Which would lead me to my next point, which is act. Now, after assessing what happened to you in the past, it is now time for you to do something. You need to act on it. Kung nalaman mo na mahina ka sa prof ed, then read more about prof ed. Kung nalaman mo na mahina ka sa gen ed, then read more about gen ed. Mga kaibigan, I think a lot of materials are available to you, may it be in your library or online. Ang dami mga kaibigan. And if you are the type of student na disciplined enough na magkaroon ng timetable for studying, do it. Pero kung hindi naman, I suggest, mga kaibigan, find a reputable review center that could help you in your endeavor. Like, come on. Now, why do you need to choose wisely sa review center mo? Kasi mga kaibigan, talagang mahalaga rin yun eh. Dapat pipili ka ng isang center that would really help you in passing the board exam for teachers who would really care about your welfare. Na hindi lang puro fanfare, hindi lang puro publicity, but you know, with genuine care. O baka sabihin nyo, bias ako kasi from MET ako. Pero you know what? It's your decision. Choose whatever review center that fits your personality. Kayong bahala. Pero I suggest, mga kaibigan, take all the help that you need. Lahat ng mga lahat na kailangan mong aralin, aralin mo. Lahat ng pwede mong gawin, gawin mo. Right? So that is my third tip for you. Act on it. Act on the weaknesses that you're able to assess a while ago. Do something. The fourth A is aspire. And my friends, as of the moment, this is very, very important. Lalo na ngayon na you feel so down, napakababa ng self-esteem mo, feeling mo ang dami mong na-disappoint ng mga tao, kaya parang wala ka ng gana magpatuloy. No, maling attitude yun, mga kaibigan. You need to aspire. Kailangan may dreams ka pa rin. Kailangan meron ka pa rin drive to continue, move on, and you know, achieve your goal. Dapat wag ka titigil. After mong matanggap, ma-accept mo, after mong ma-assess yung mga pagkakamali mo, after mong gumawa or act on it, my friends, don't forget to dream again. Don't forget to aspire again. Don't forget to have drive again para kumuha at ipasa ang board exam for teachers. Yun, aspire. Very important. The fifth A is acknowledge. Now, ano nga ba yung kailangan mong i-acknowledge? Well, very simple. You need to acknowledge that there is one supreme being or God who sees everything. Alam niya yung mga paghihirap mo, nakita niya yung mga pagsikap mo, at alam din niya ang proper or right time for you. Alam niya kung kailan ibibigay sa'yo everything that your heart desires, right? And tingin ko mahalaga yun, to cling on to something, to hope for something, and to believe na talagang there is a God who sees everything, right? Pero syempre, sabi nga nila, nasa Diyos ang awa, nasa tao ang gawa. And I think, my friends, with these five steps, kaya-kaya na makapag-move on at makapag-move forward. Basta, my friends, huwag lang susuko. Remember, laging may pag-asa. And the great thing about the board exam for teachers, you can take it, I think, as much as you can, mga kaibigan. Quick story nga eh. Meron kaming isang estudyante sa MET na naka 14 times siya nag-exam. Imagine that, 14 times. So yung 13 times na ginawa niya, nag-self-study lang siya. Dahil sabi niya, baka kailangan niya ng tulong, baka kailangan niya ng review center. Come on, MET, right? And after being with us, finally, sa ika 14th take niya, she's now a licensed professional teacher. So wag mawawala ng pag-asa. Go lang ng go at wag na wag susuko. Remember, my friends, my five tips for you are: number one is accept. Number two is assess. Number three is act. Number four is aspire. And number five is acknowledge. Now, mga kaibigan, I hope this video was able to help you. And thank you for watching and see you again next time. Bye, everybody. Tell me what to do.